Long-term use of minoxidil. Can it kill the transplanted hair? 4 years ago, I had a hair transplant. Up to this moment, I use minoxidil 15% once a day at night. I use it for transplant hairs and other normal hairs. Some areas are only with transplanted hairs. Before hair transplant, there was no hair. I use minoxidil all over top of head. For a year, I have noticed much less transplanted hairs. Is it possible that minoxidil kills the transplanted hair follicles?
Thank you for your question. You state in your question that you're using 15% minoxidil, and you're asking if minoxidil can actually damage or kill transplanted hair. And you're noticing that after the course of 1 year that you have fewer transplanted hair. Well, I can give you some guidance on this question. I'm a board-certified cosmetic surgeon and fellowship-trained oculofacial plastic surgeon practicing in Manhattan and Long Island for over 20 years. Hair transplant has been a big part of my practice for this time. And in addition, I'm the founder of Trichostem Hair Regeneration Centers, a non-surgical treatment alternative for hair loss using a wound healing technology that we developed in our practice. So I can certainly speak with a lot of experience about situations like yours. Now, of course, in this question, unfortunately, I don't have the complete story as to the timing of when you had the transplant, when you started using the 15% minoxidil, and what that may mean when you observe fewer transplanted hairs. But let's start with, first of all, the question of why be on 15% minoxidil. I realize that there is a certain percentage of our colleagues who believes in these custom formulations, and certainly in our practice we have tried these various formulations. The idea is that if we can't get something which is like over-the-counter, like a 5% minoxidil, and we believe that there's value in using a higher percentage, then you get these custom or compounded pharmaceuticals created and provide them to patients. So I'm not necessarily denying any potential benefit, but let's say we're talking about the transplanted hair after about 1 year after transplantation. You're always looking at a slice of time, and it may not be that the minoxidil is causing the hair graft to shed and not come back, but it might be that you've caught the transplanted hair in a particular stage of the growth cycle. To understand this, let's just go over basic hair growth cycles. There's an anagen phase, which is the active growing phase. There's catagen phase, which is an intermediate phase where the hair is still present, but it's no longer actively growing. And then there's the telogen phase, when the hair sheds. And during that telogen phase, there are 3 to 4 months of lag at a minimum before new hair growth occurs. So in our practice, when we do these surgeries, but as of late, we've been actually doing a lot more of a treatment we called hair regeneration. And I'm just going to give you the context of how minoxidil fits into this equation. As far as I'm concerned, minoxidil does help people with hair thinning because it appears to prolong the growth cycle of thinning hair, which means that the hairs that are thinning progressively at least stay around a little bit longer. It's important to understand, going back to the growth cycle, the anagen phase, or the active growth phase, decreases with hair thinning, and the telogen phase actually increases, which means that you shed a hair and then you don't have a hair to replace that hair for a longer period of time, and when that hair comes in, it's thinner. Now, when we do this treatment called hair regeneration, we figured out that essentially for people with thinning hair, once they have the treatment, essentially their hair has stopped thinning. In other words, we no longer need the benefit of minoxidil. And I've been doing this for many years, and so I have a lot of clinical data. In fact, we have patients who come to us from all over the world, and we really rigorously collect a lot of information with every visit. When we see our patients in microscopy photos, standardized position photos of the top of the head and various views, digital photography. And I've made observations because a lot of times people have been using, with thinning hair, have been using minoxidil for a long time. And in some ways it becomes like a security blanket. What I've observed is that for a lot of our patients, I'll actually stop the minoxidil about a month or so after the procedure, if the patient wants to. Sometimes people want to just stay on their regimens because they just want to, until their hair starts to really regrow and they see it, they'll stick with the regimen that they were doing before the treatment. So I think that in that respect, transplanted hair by definition is not hair that should be thinning. Now, of course, we can have a long discussion about the source of hair in procedures such as FUE grafts. But let's say you did a standardized FUT or strip surgery, or even an FUE. Those hairs are genetically resistant to shedding. Therefore, those hairs should actually be fairly resilient and be able to grow. But something that not everyone always fully appreciates is that a certain percentage of the hair grafts don't actually make it. They don't continue to grow. There's a certain loss. We've seen patients who come to us for surgery who had mega session procedures and they lost 90% of their grafts done elsewhere. And it was, you know, we were left with much less hair to work with to do surgery. So it is a potential. And in the case of FUEs, approximately 30% of hairs are actually transected, which means that those hairs don't even actually have the root when they're placed. So they can actually just shed and go away. So I think you need to speak to the doctor who performed your surgery and the doctor who is prescribing the 15% minoxidil, and get an orientation of what's going on and why you should continue using minoxidil. If it's to maintain your existing hair, well, it might be that the minoxidil itself may be inflammatory or irritating to the scalp, and it might be causing some breakage or some potential shedding of the hairs. But not knowing what the vehicle is or the method in which the minoxidil is being delivered in terms of the formulation, I can't just say that that's certain. So you have a reason to be concerned. And I think that discussing this with your doctor and reviewing your photos, you know, when we do our surgeries, we do a plan. We take pictures immediately after surgery and we take pictures throughout the follow-up period. It's just what we do, just to track progress. And if there was hair in a certain area and there isn't hair now, it may not be really a minoxidil issue or an inflammatory issue, but at least be able to document, you know, what does it look like 3 months from now, 6 months from now, 9 months from now. You know, there may be that these hairs are just temporarily not growing. But again, without more detailed information, I can't give you a more definitive answer. So I hope that was helpful. I wish you the best of luck, and thank you for your question.